Namashivai student, today I am going to start another chapter, Atom, and this is part 120. This is another topic of Atom. So previously we have already learned from this chapter what is Rutherford atomic model and alpha trajectory. So today we are going to learn electron orbits. So in Rutherford nuclear model of an atom, which involve classical concept and picture of an atom, which is atom as an electrically neutral sphere consisting of a very small massive positive charged nucleus at the center, which is surrounded by the revolving electrons in their respective dynamically stable orbit, and there is a force of attraction which is Fe between the revolving electron and the nucleus, provided the requisite centripetal force to keep them in their orbit. So there is a stable orbit in the hydrogen atom, so Fe equals to Fc. So this is the centripetal force and this is the attraction force. So we know that Fe, force of attraction, which is equivalent to mv square by r, and centripetal force equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught e square by r square. So from this equation we can calculate the radius, orbital radius, for r equals to e square by 4 pi epsilon naught mv square. So we can also find the kinetic energy and the electrostatic potential energy of the electron in the hydrogen atom. So we know that the kinetic energy k equals to half mv square. So if we want to put the value, so we can we get that e square by 8 pi epsilon naught r. And what is the potential energy, which is equivalent to minus e square divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r. So what is the total energy, kinetic energy plus potential energy? We know that the kinetic energy equals to e square by 8 pi epsilon naught r minus e square by 4 pi epsilon naught r. So after calculating, we get that minus e square by 8 pi epsilon naught r. There is a total energy of the electron is negative. It implies that the fact that the electron is bound to the nucleus and E were positive, an electron will not flow a close orbit around the nucleus. This is the atomic spectrum. Each and every element has a characteristic spectrum of radiation and it emits. When an atomic gas or vapor is excited at low pressure, usually by passing the electric current through it, it emits radiation has a spectrum which contains certain specific wavelengths only. So the emission line, there is an emission line spectrum, and it consists of bright lines on a dark background. The spectrum which is emitted by atomic hydrogen, which is shown in the figure, this one. So the study of emission line spectrum of a material can be therefore serve as a type of fingerprint and identification of the gases. So the light, white light, which is passes through a gas, so we can analyze the transmitted light using a spectrometer, we find some dark lines in the spectrum. Each dark lines correspond to those wavelength which were found in the emission line spectrum of the gases. So this is called the absorption spectra of the material of the gas. Spectral series. The frequency of the light which emitted by a particular element would exhibit some irregular pattern. Hydrogen is the simplest atom and it has the simplest spectrum. In the observed spectrum, however, the first sight, there does not seem to be any resemble or order or regularity in the spectral lines. So the spacing between the lines within certain sets of hydrogen spectrum decreases in the regular way. It will decrease. So the first such series was observed by Swedish school teacher Blamer in the visible region of the hydrogen spectrum. So the series is called Blamer series. The line of the longest wavelength, which is 656.3 nanometer, and in the rate is called H alpha. The next line of wavelength 486.1 nanometer and blue green is called H beta, and third line 434.1 nanometer, which is the violet light, H gamma. So the wavelength decreases and the line appear closer together. are weaker in intensity. So Blumer found the simplest empirical formula for the wavelength. This is 1 by lambda r bracket 1 by 2 square minus 1 by n square. So this is lambda is the wavelength and r is a constant, which is called Rydberg constant. The value is n maybe have integral of 3, 4, 5, and the value is value of r is Rydberg constant 1.097 × 10⁻⁷ per meter. So for line n we can find the value of lambda, which is 656.3 nanometer. And for 4, it is if n equals to 4, then we can say that this is h beta line, and n equals to infinity, one obtain the limit of the series at lambda equals to 364.6 nanometer. This is the shortest wavelength in the Blumer series. So no further distinct lines which is appear, instead only a plain continuous spectrum is seen. Next, other series of spectra of hydrogen were subsequently discovered. After the discoverers as Lamann, Prussian, and Brackett and Pivot series. So Lamann series is what? Lamann series, which is 1 by lambda equals to r 1 by 1 square minus 1 by n square. So this is here n equals to 2, 3, 4 and so on. Passion series, which is 1 by lambda equals to r 1 by 3 square minus 1 by n square. Bracket series is 1 by lambda equals to r 1 by 4 square minus 1 by n square. And Pifon series is 1 by lambda equals to r 1 by 5 square minus 1 by n square. Where n is 6, 7, 8 and so on. For bracket n is 5, 6, 7. And for passion this is, the value of n is 4. 5, 6 and so on. The Lamann series is a is in the ultraviolet, and passion and bracket series is the infrared region. The Blumer formula, which can be from where we can in the term of frequency of the light, we can write the right in the term of frequency of light. So C equals to F lambda, or we can write that mu lambda. So 1 by lambda equals to mu by C. So we can write that mu equals to R C 1 by 2 square minus 1 by n square. So there is only a few elements, which is hydrogen, slightly ionized helium, and doubly ionized lithium, and the spectra can be represented by a simple formula. So there is the wavelength that hydrogen atom radiate or absorb. So this is the wavelength. Bohr model of the hydrogen atom. The model of the atom, which is proposed by Rutherford, assumes that the atom, which consisting of the central nucleus and revolving electron, is stable, much like sun planet system, which the model imitates. Now there are some fundamental differences between the two situations. The planetary system is held gravitational force. The nucleus electron system, electron system being charged object. So interact by Coulomb force, Coulomb law of force. So the object which moves in the circle is being constantly accelerated, and the acceleration being centripetal in nature. According to classical electromagnetic theory, the accelerating charged particle emits radiation in the form of electromagnetic waves. The energy energy of an accelerating electron should their accelerating electron the energy which is emitted to the accelerating electron and continuously decreases. The electron would spiral inward and eventually fall into the nucleus. So for this, the atom cannot be stable. So according to the classical electromagnetic theory, the frequency of the electromagnetic waves which is emitted by the revolving electron is equal to the frequency of the revolution. The electrons spiral inward, and their angular velocities, hence their frequency would change continuously. So they would emit a constantly spectrum, and the coordination to the line spectrum actually observed. Rutherford model tells that the part of the story that implying that classical ideas that not sufficient to explain the atomic structure. So this is the electron. It comes towards nucleus. So it accelerated atomic electron set spiral into the nucleus and loses into the nucleus at its loses energy. So this is the drawback for the Rutherford atomic model. So this is all about my today's topic. Tomorrow I'll be going to start another topic from the chapter. Thank you, student, for watching this video.